Hey, we are back. Anthony Devlin here alongside
Lightning Monroe, sitting here for a match to see the Rebel Guerrillas in action.
Bringing back, this is pre-recorded, which is why we could have Lightning Monroe, my broadcast partner, here. And you can see him on the ringside. So I'm pretty sure we're going to hear all about himself. But before you get to talking about yourself, let's talk about this young guy here, Big Red Grizzly, in his fifth match ever, DWI or anywhere else.
Might be his fifth match, period, in there with Big Dave Guevara.
Are you trying to say period as in his last as well?
As in the end of him.
I don't think that it's going
to
go down
Guevara
that easy. I
know Dave is subject to snap this boy in half.
I know you're a big proponent of Dave Guevara, but I think this kid can handle himself. He's been doing all right. I'm not saying that he's ready for, let's say, Steve.
No, it didn't look like he was ready for that big boot in the belly, now was it?
No, he was not. But I gotta say, he's one of this. Oh, look at that!
I wasn't real happy when that happened.
Beautiful counter there.
Yeah, I'll give him. He's got a few muscles. He can do a little.
We're not even talking about the muscles, but this influx of young guns here at DWI is insane.
Yeah, there's a lot of good young competitors here in DWI now. Big guys, young, ready to wrestle and tear somebody up.
Hungry,
but
big,
ain't
strong.
None of them got nothing on Dave Guevara.
Well,
except for Big Red at the moment, but it's all in there. Dave's got a plan.
I know what you're doing. You were spiking the camera so you can see that he had him in that armbar there, huh?
What,
so he
arm
just
bar?
Readjust.
Oh,
just readjust
that armbar.
Definitely. Can see it clearly now, huh?
Yeah, it looks like he pulled his hair a little bit trying to get him down in the arm bar. I don't know that you can't really trust this Big Red guy.
I don't think that he has to resort to underhanded shenanigans to compete against Guevara. If anything, I would say your boy is the one we have to look out for.
Dog, what are you
He's
talking
been known
about?
To, you know, a little underhanded himself. Not all the time, but he's been known. Oh, very smart move.
That was brilliance on the part of Dave Guevara there. See, that's why the rest of the young, big talent coming up, they don't stand a chance when Dave's around.
Here's the thing, I got to give you credit because he's only been in the business a year and a half, and he's thinking that quickly on his feet already. Like veteran moves, veteran ringmanship. Ring generalship in there. It's impressive how far he's come in such a short time. I really believe that, you know, with a little bit more time. Oh, who the what the? With a little
close
bit more
to Halloween, there it appears we might have a ghost in the DWI building.
It sure did scare me, but I'll tell you, what was I saying? That just frightened the heck out of me. Big Dave Guerrero. Oh,
right back into
smart.
The action there. See again, the skill that Dave brings into these matches, his opponents. Oh, that's what happens to all of Dave's opponents.
A little being.
I was trying.
Not
to,
enough experience, though, because he ran right into that. That was like, oh, but he turned that over. That's some big hammered fist right there.
Look at it.
Thuds.
Illegal punches to the head.
Yeah, those
that's
things are
clearly
so
a cheater.
Oh, that was a big clothesline there.
I think he pulled the hair again. Big punches. See how tough Big Dave Guevara is? He's not even knocked off his feet.
Launches him across the ring. Oh, big splash in the corner.
Still on his feet. That's how strong
and
tough of a competitor.
Nobody has ever questioned his toughness at all. Just saying right now, that Big Red Grizzly is putting him through the ringer.
Yeah, he's got him at the moment, but it won't last that long before Big Dave Guevara is able to come back.
He's got him down. He's wearing down that shoulder and that arm bar there.
Yeah, he tried real hard, but that's a big old arm to be grabbing on.
Yeah, but again, going back to Dave Guevara, I think with a little bit more experience and maybe just a little bit more gym time,
right,
the sky is the limit for your boy. Like, you guys, there would be no stopping him. I honestly believe that.
I agree, and with moves like that and the way that he dominates,
he doesn't waste
Red Grizzly
waste motion. He doesn't waste time.
That's right. It's just vicious. Got a takedown on
Gator roll on his arm.
Big Red. Dave Guevara showing how it's done in there against Big Red.
He's got him a little close to the ropes. Again, if Big Red was a little bit more ring savvy, he would know that all he has to do is reach out with his legs and he could get this broke.
Yeah, well, nobody ever accused him of being a wrestling scholar.
Well, he is new to this. I think he's some kind of
new to them knees too. Looks like he's new to the canvas also.
Sure took an eye. Those are some big knees.
That's how Dave Guevara
does it. Ribs are only so fragile.
Dave Guevara clearly in command.
Wow, those are some big right hands.
Not even allowing Big Red to crawl up from the ground.
Well, it's a smart thing to do. It's a sound plan. He's got the big guy down. Keep him down. Why would he let him up? He's working on the spine there.
The
Your spine doesn't bend that way, does it?
Breaking the big man down there.
Unless you're a yogi, I don't think that's really going to feel too good.
Yeah, I don't think he's going to be hollering timber here in a minute. He's going to be hollering, oh, my back, oh, my back. Dave Guevara has got him up. He's got him hooked. Oh, big butterfly suplex on the big man. All the way up in the air. Oh, and look at him. He just don't have sense enough to know that Dave Guevara is going to win no matter what.
Well, that's just a testament to the fight in Big Red Grizzly. He's not looking to give up. It's going to take more than that. He's definitely proved that. His first outing at a DWI, in the DWI building, he actually was rendered unconscious because he would not submit to the Texas Cloverleaf.
Yeah, that's true. Big Dummy was rendered unconscious. I agree with you on that.
You know, I'm not going to say that allowing yourself to be put to sleep is the smartest move ever. But it sure does show a lot about your character.
Yeah.
And there's no questioning that.
How much character you think he's got left after his face was just stomped into the mat by Dave Guevara?
Well, that big old beard might have padded it up a little bit. I don't know. But that sure had to hurt.
You think that the taste of the mat is new to him?
I wouldn't want to taste that.
Dave Guevara pounding on him. Here we go.
Oh, what
is this? He's going to stretch him out a little bit.
He didn't even apply the hold yet and was already grabbing for the rope. And oh, well, there you go. What's that about?
What's what about? I had to check the rope. Dave was saying there was something wrong with the rope, and the referee wasn't looking at the rope, so I had to check the rope. Me and Dave were checking the rope, making sure that everything was safe.
It seems like you're trying to...
You got to have a safe ring.
Well, I don't know about all that. Clearly looks like something different to me, but how about I just take your word for it?
Oh, there, we were checking the, oh, look, and the referee, he got mad because we was checking the rope. He didn't really like that much.
Barely able to get him over for that hip toss, but he gets him over.
Yeah.
Big clothesline in the corner. Big Red trying to gather himself against the ropes there.
I'd like to point out that he had to have the referee help him.
Fair enough. Duly noted.
Oh, and
slung
a reverse into the corner.
Dave, boot delivered.
Dave ate
eats
the boot
that
to the face.
Oh, what? Big leg scissors. What?
Leg did scissors?
Did you know that this big guy was capable of something like that?
Well, I know he's athletic. I didn't think he was capable of all that.
Someone's been doing some training.
I'll give him some points on that one. It takes quite a lot to take Big Dave Guevara down.
I'm after a move like that, I'm really excited to see where this big guy's career is going to be headed. Although, we're talking like Big Dave's out and going for the timber slam. And, of course, there. What happened there?
Well, see, we had decided.
Why are you dropping elbows on him?
Because we wanted to beat him up for taking Big Dave Guevara down with his leg scissors there. We just felt like we couldn't allow that to stand. And so we decided that we was going to teach Big Red Grizzly there.
But don't you feel like you just took that away? Don't you think that maybe your partner would have been able to get away from that move, counter, and maybe get the win on his own?
You
actually just caused him a DQ.
Of course he could have.
That was a disqualification putting him in the losing column. Oh, now you guys are just out of control
now. See, technically, Technically, he won.
Oh, well.
Technically, he won.
No, come
right
on.
Right there. Technically, he won. Technically, he won because he pinned the man.
Technically,
and counted to three.
Technically, he did not win because the match was
yes,
thrown
see,
out.
Yes, there's his hand being raised in victory. Raised in victory.
By you. This seems like some
this
serious
is, this
propaganda
is what,
stuff.
This is what you should remember.
This is not signed the contract.
The Rebel Gorillas with their hands in their air and their opponent laid out on the mat.
If you say so, but I'm not too sure about that. Shenanigans, I say. Shenanigans.